Hi everyone, in this video, I want to talk about one of the most important parts of reaction engineering. Stoichiometry, although basic, is very important to examine when designing your reactors. In the previous video, we learned how to perform elemental balances. So, if you missed that one, I'll put a link in the description below. We could perform elemental balances as mass is always conserved no matter what. However, can we say the same about moles? Well, no, moles are not conserved in a reaction. So our moles into our reaction are not necessarily going to be the moles out of our reaction. And in gas phase reactions, this could cause large concerns in the gas phase reactions, as our pressure can greatly increase if we're not careful. We know this from our ideal gas law. We can see here that if the moles of our gas increases, then our pressure will also greatly increase. This is less of a concern with liquid phase reactions, as changes in our moles do not greatly affect the pressure exerted from the liquids, as much of the liquids are already relatively tightly packed compared to that of the gas molecules. Let's examine the complete combustion of ethanol. Assuming that all the components are in the gas phase, it is clear that we have 4 moles of gas on our left, our reactants, and 5 moles of gas on our right, which are our products. I just wanted to mention this early on in the course, as when we get to future reactor designs, we must take this into account. So, this is something just to be aware of as we start talking more into reactor design and pressure constraints. So, although this video was quick, I want you to remember a few things moving forward. Stoichiometry is extremely important in reaction engineering and chemistry in general. So, always ensure that your chemical equation is properly balanced. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of what mole balance stoichiometry is and how we find the stoichiometry of a reaction using a mole balance. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.